नमामि भगवत्पादं शंकरं लोकशंकरं शंकरं शंकराचार्यं केशवं बादरायणं सूत्रभाष्यकृतौ वंदे भगवन्तौ पुनः पुनः ईश्वरो गुरुरात्मेति मुक्तिभेदविभागिने व्योमवद्व्याप्तदेहाय दक्षिणामूर्तये नमः। ॐ सहनावतु सहनौ भुनक्तु सह वीर्यं करवावहै तेजस्विनावधीतमस्तु मा विद्विषावहै। ॐ शान्ति शान्ति शान्तिः। यो ब्रह्माण विधाति पूर्वं वेदागश्च प्रणोति तस्मै तपं हृदयमात्मबुद्धिप्रकाशं मुक्षुर्वै शरणं सम्प्रपद्ये। ॐ शान्ति शान्ति शान्तिः। श्रीचिद्घनगणेशाय नमो। वयं सुखं नित्यं सप्रकाशं व्यापकं नाम रूपयो अधिष्ठानं बुद्धिबोध्यं बुद्धेर्दृक्यत्व निर्मलापारं सर्ववेदान्तवेद्यं प्रत्यक्परमः तदेवाहन्नमत्वन्यदिति मे निश्चिता मतिः। So we have looked at the simile whereby the thorns were separated from the lotuses by the passerby. In the exemplified, Bhagavan Vyasacharya has separated out the confusing Dvaita statements from the Advaita through Brahma Sutra. And Puranas also, there is a classification in Puranas also which has been done. But here the focus is primarily Brahma Sutra. And then with such segregation and protection of Advaita Tattva, establishing it, separating it from the confusing Dvaita statements, which are primarily based on logic and nothing else, the sadhu quotes the teacher teaching Agrada Deva in the sapna, in his sapna, as Naisha Tarkena Matirapaneya. So it's a Vaidika statement, Ityadi Shrutehe. This is the teaching given. Tasmad Brahmanishtacharya Upadesha Eva Atra Utsangaha. So that protection, like a mother takes the child on her lap and protects, similarly, Brahmanishtacharya Upadesha Eva Atra Utsanga. That itself is the protection, the Upadesha of a Brahmanishtacharya. Punarapi Vedavyasa Rupi Bhagavan Chintayamasa. Further, he thought, even after segregation, to protect the Advaita Tattva, basically, initially to protect the Shishyas, he wanted to separate out. So, initially, focus was to protect the Shishyas, who should not be confused by the Dvaita Acharyas. Now, he thought further, Punarapi Ayam Bhedavadi Anyanapi Kamakarma Rupa Kantaka Marge Pravartya Brahmayediti Ataha Anyeshamapi Swashishyanam Brahmanivrutte Nyaya Vicharatmaka Sutra Rupa Jalena Vedanta Vakya Rupa Vrukshan Kantaki Drumebhyo Vyabhajat. So from the group of thorns which are going to prick like a thorn, that kind of a logic. So like the thorns are used to, you know, it is used to take away. A needle is used, for example, not a thorn per se, but a needle is used to take away the thorn. So using the visha, you take away visha. Similarly, using logic, this logic has to be contradicted, countered, and thereby protect the akrosha of the tarkikas. He wrote the Brahma Sutras because they still have this logic with them, by which they can end up confusing others. So Punarapya Ayam Bhedavadi, again, even if it is separated, still they can mix up and then still use logic and confuse the shishyas. Therefore, and not only in a particular darshana, in all darshanas which are not advaita. So, kama karma rupa kantaka marge pravartya. Brahmayediti, ataha neshamapi swashishyanam brahmanivritte nyaya vicharatmaka sutra rupa jalina. So, protection is with the nyaya sutra. That itself is the jala. He has, what he is doing now is the nyaya sutras, which are brahma sutras, nyaya prasthana, using that. So, the sutras, like a thread, they run through the statements that are made, which are brief statements, aphorisms. Like a sutra, they come together because there is anuvritti from the earlier sutra. Athato brahma jidnyasa, that brahma will have anuvritti. Sorry. So this is the kavacha. He has made a net using that sutra to counter the logicians and protect the shishyas. Vane santi dvidha vrikshaha, sakantaka vrikshaha, nishkantakaha, pushpa phlashalinaha vrikshascheti. So some trees are bearing fruits and there are flowers, whereas the others are having none of that. They just have thorns. Nishkantaka vriksha yadi jalena kantaki vrikshebhya vivakta bhavanti tada tat pushpani kantakeshu na pateyuhu. Evam vede api santi dvidhani vakyani. Tatra kanichid vakyani phalaihi karma stuti dvara bahirmukham purusham karmani pravartayanti anyani vakyani karma phalanam anityatvadi dosha nirupana dvara karmana sakashat purusham nivartayanti. So Vedas also have clear division, whereby one part is committed to karma. How? Phalaihi karma stuti dvara. So some of these statements, they have arthavada, or they present the phalas in such an attractive manner by praising the karma. Thereby a person who is already focused outward, he is dragged into these karmas. Bahir mukham purusham karmani pravartayanti. There are other statements which are karma phalanam anichyatvadi dosha nirupana dvara, which show the karma kanda, karmas and upasanas as giving anitya phala. Thereby karmana sakasha purusham nivartayanti. They withdraw the person. So nivritti marga and pravritti marga. Initial is pravritti marga. There is nivritti marga as well. Nivritti marga leads to moksha. So let's look at tippana. Apama soma amruta bhuma ityadini. So he is given an example. Then the ninda of karma is done by tadyatheha karma chito lokaha kshiyate eva meva mutra punya chito lokaha kshiyate ityadini. So there is chandogya mantra, which says that just like karma chita is karma krita, which is the loka, which is a karma phala. That kind of phala will exhaust in time, because as much is the karma, so much is the result. So as soon as the amount of karma accumulated, punya accumulated, exhaust, the phala will also exhaust. So whether it is experience here or elsewhere, iha loka, so lokyante iti lokaha, or lokyate iti lokaha, the phala, karma phala, experience exhausts. Even if there is an erroneous thinking that I get sukha in indulgence, if there is punya on, then only there will be sukha. So that punya exhausting, the sukha will also go away. Just like it is here, amutra, in the other loka also, punya chitaha lokaha kshiyate. Vyasa sutra meva anartha nivrutyupayaha. So what is the upaya for all the adversities to go away? Vyasa sutra, Brahma sutra, Veda vyaso Veda vakyani yubhajya स्वकीय ब्रह्मसूत्रेण वेदकथानां सकलवाक्यानां निवृत्तौ एव तात्पर्यं न तु प्रवृत्तौ कस्यचिदपि वाक्यस्य इति बोधयामास. इन ब्रह्मसूत्र ही हैज एनालाइज्ड द उपनिषद मंत्रास एंड शोन दैट ऑल दीज मंत्रास आर कमिटेड टू मुक्ति. Even the Karmakanda mantras are not really giving moksha as a phala. They give anicca phala, and through that they want you to outgrow your karma, kama, raga dvesha adi, and thereby looking at it as anicca phala, pariksha lokan, and seeing that how the phala exhaust the person would take to Vedanta and then be led to moksha jnanena. So no vakya, no mantra is committed to pravritti. Even the pravritti is having a tatparya in moksha through nivritti by generating chitta shuddhi. वस्तुतस्तु प्रवृत्तिबोधकवाक्यानामपि स्वाभाविक प्रवृत्तेः निषिद्ध कर्म प्रवृत्तेश्च पुरुषं निवर्त्य विहितकर्मसु पुरुषस्य प्रवृत्तिमुत्पाद्य विहितकर्मानुष्ठानेन शुद्धान्तःकरणस्य पुरुषस्य सर्वकर्मफलेभ्यः वैराग्यपूर्वकं ज्ञाननिष्ठासम्पादने एव तात्पर्यम् इति निवृत्तावेव सर्ववेदवाक्यानां तात्पर्यम्. सो थ्रू चित्तशुद्धि ऑल दीस कर्मस् what they do initially, they take away the person from the nishiddha karma. So swabhavika pravruttehe nishiddha karma pravruttescha, there is a tendency which is there in everyone to give into raga dvesha. That is there in animals also, birds also. Similarly, human beings also have a natural tendency to meet the desires which are not going to give you sukha at all, but there is a confusion that there is sukha there. At least it is anicca, that much has to be accepted or analysis. And nishiddha karma or not, that analysis is not done. Therefore, for human beings, there is a dharma shastra. That dharma shastra, which is revealing the sambandha between karma and phala, which is adrishta. What it is doing, it takes away the person from indulging in nishiddha karma. If a person has to do swashrama karma, meaning if a person has to do varnashrama dharma completely in any era, then the person will not have enough time and energy to do anything else. That is why the society is divided in such a manner that a person who is doing a particular set of karmas, he won't be doing other set of karmas. He may have learnt all sets of karmas in childhood when there was no duty beyond nitya karma. There may not have been naimittika karma, ityadi. Kamya karma definitely won't be there. So as a brahmachari, all karmas and upasanas may have been studied, including Vedanta also, in chanting, swashaka at least. But as the person goes into the second stage of life, the karmas increase so much that there is no time for doing anything else. So a person has to pick into the role as ordained by his varna and ashrama. Those karmas will be done. These will definitely lead to chitta shuddhi for that specific person. Now, in that role, entire day is consumed if a person goes by the guidance of the Vedas, thereby the person is protected from the Nishiddha Karma. So Kamya Karmas are also there to take away a person from the Nishiddha Karmas. Oh, you like this? Then do this. Even after Nitya Karma, if there is something pending, oh, you do this. If you want this, do this. This is a right way to achieve things. So a person is drawn away from Nishiddha Karma. Swabhavika Pravritti, a person does not have enough time and energy left after doing Nitya Naimittika Karmas. Then what remains is the Ragadvesha which is being dealt with. Over a period of time, these Ragadveshas one will outgrow using Nitya Naimittika Karma to that particular Varnashrama. Then Purusham Nivartya Vihita Karmasu Purushasya Parvati Mutpadya Vihita Karma Anushtanin. What is going to happen through these Vihita Karmas? Shuddha Antakkarana. Antakkarana will become Shuddha, and the person who has that Shuddha Antakkarana, Shuddha Antakkaranasya Purushasya Sarva Karma Phalebhya Vairagya Purvakam Jnana Nishtha Sampadane Eva Tatvaryam. The final goal is to lead the person via Chitta Shuddhi into Vairagya and Akanksha for the Nitya Phala, which can never be from karma, because whatever karma gives, it will be limited in time, quantity, everything. In all ways, it will be limited. It won't be Purna. So, Nivrutta Veva Sarva Veda Vakyanam Tatparyam. Even through Pravritti Marga, through Chitta Shuddhi, Vairagya, and then Nivrutti. That is the process in which the Vakyas work, including the Karma Kanda Vakyas. Arthavada Vakyanam Karmapala Bodhakatvam Api Guda Jivhika Nyaye Naiva Natu Tesham Vakyanam Phale Tatparyam. Arthavada Vakyas, they exaggerate things, saying that, oh, if you go to this loka, you are done. But it isn't true, because they'll contradict other Veda Vakyas. If you put them together, then you know that it is an exaggeration, so that a person is weaned away from the Nishiddha Karma and goes to Vihita Karma. So, Goda Jivika Nyayana. The idea is to push the bitter pill by using jaggery. Natu tesham vakyanam phale tatparyam. There is no tatparya in the phala really. Amum artham shri veda vyasa eva swasutraihi bodhayati evam vyasa sutra jnatva purushaha kama karmebhyo nivartate. So this is revealed by Brahma Sutras by analyzing all sorts of mantras in the Shruti. So anyway, we have seen this Gudajivika Nyaya. I mentioned it. There is not much there. I'll skip the tippana. Yatha sutra nirmitam jalam kantakebhya pushpani nivarayati tatha vyasa sutram idam brahma mimamsa sutram kama karmanushthana purusham nivarayati iti jalatvena rupitam. It is called as a net to protect, used to separate out, segregate and create boundaries, because it is just like a net. These Brahma Sutras are just like a net. What they are going to do is that kama karma anushthana purusham nivarayati. They take away the pravritti of the person. So there is a segregation. Therefore, just like the thorns are separated from the flowers, the kama karma anushthana purusham nivarayati. Brahma Sutra. Chakara Sutram Yovyasa Naishkarmyar Thavibhodakam Tamaham Dasa Bhutasan Pranamami Muhur Muhu. So Muhur Muhu Pranamami. How? Having this Dasa Bhava, Dasa Bhutasan. Whom do I worship? This Vyasa. Vyasam Tam. Who Yaha Sutram Chakara? Who made these Brahma Sutras? Why? Naishkarmyartha Vibhodakam. These sutras, so this is a Hetu Karma Visheshana for the revelation of Naishkarmya Artha. Atma is Nishkarma, land there. So for that purpose, these Brahma Sutras have been created, and to that kind of a Vyasa, I bow down again and again. Agrita Devasya Traya Prashnaha. Now, Agradadeva has these prashnas. In this Swapna, because he has found a guru now, he has been looking for answers. So he asks questions now, because now Vedas are revealing all these karma, upasana, jnana. Then there are several darshanas based on these astika darshanas, nastika darshanas, not based on Vedas but Shuddha Tarka. Others who claim to have basis in Shruti, they are also using a lot of Tarka. Now Brahma Sutra is analyzing this, but very difficult to understand. So it's revealing what the Shruti Tatparya is. In that Tatparya, is it covering my questions? This is the idea of Agradadeva. Aham kaha, first question. Who am I? Basic question. Samsarasya karta kaha. This samsara that I find outside me, who is the creator of that samsara? Mukte karanam kim? What is the karana for mukti of samsara? Samsara, this world continuing, I, the objectifier of that world, continue to be there. So samsara, meaning the world continuing, I will continue to be there. So samsaranam, my continuous, continuously being born and dying is all dukkha rupa. So that is included in this question. When I say aham kaha, samsara se karta kaha, there is a sambandha between this aham and samsara. Who created this subject-object division also? Not only the world of objects, but who created me to be a subject towards this world? All these questions are included there. Mukte karanam kim? What is the karana for mukti, whereby I won't be a samsari? This samsara somebody has created, and I have this samsara. So samsara asya asti, asya mama, asti iti aham samsari. Therefore I need mukti. Mukte karanam kim? What is the karana for this mukti? Jnana. So jnanam uta karma, athava upasanam, athava karma upasane ubhayapi iti. So whether it is jnana, karma, upasana, or both karma and upasana. Tatra, he Bhagavan, aham kaha iti prashnasya ayam abhipraya. So these are basic questions, but then there are a lot of hidden meaning there. What is the question there really? Kim aham deha swarupaha athava dehad bhinnaha, aham manushya iti mama deha iti cha dvidha pratiti sambhavat me samshayo jataha. Why is this question there? Why does Agradadeva have this question? Why not everyone have this very question? They may have some kind of such question, but not this very question. So whether I am limited to the body or I am different from the body, when I say I am a manushya, I am a human being, I have a human body, therefore I am a human being. So I am a human being by being manushya deha swarupaha, therefore aham manushya. This is one conclusion. Then I also have a thinking that mama deha, this human body is mine. They are contradictory. Iti cha dvidha pratiti sambhavat. Since both thoughts are there and both are contradictory, me samshayo jataha. So for a person who can think, will definitely have such doubt as to who am I really? Am I really this body which I think I am, but then I also know that it is mine. So is it raho shiravat shashti or not? Am I one with the body or am I separate? Yadi bhavan man dehat bhinnam braviti tarhi. Now even if you tell me that I am different from the body, then aham king kartru bhoktru swarupaha uta akriyaha. Am I a karta and a bhokta, or I do not have any kriyas, even if I am different from the body? यदि माम भवान अक्रियम कथयति, इफ यू से नो आई एम अक्रिय, आई एम नॉट कर्ता भोक्ता, देन तर्हि अहम किम सर्व शरीरेषु एकः उत अनेकः इति. देन फर्दर इन दैट सेम क्वेश्चन, व्हाट इज हिडन? इवन इफ यू टेल मी दैट आई एम डिफरेंट फ्रॉम द बॉडी माइंड सेंस कॉम्प्लेक्स, डू आई हैव क्रियाज और नॉट, एम आई कर्ता भोक्ता और नॉट? बिकॉज अदर दर्शनास टेल मी दैट आई एम अ कर्ता, इफ नॉट अ कर्ता आई एम अ भोक्ता. Sankhya tells me that I am a bhokta without being a karta. Sorry. Then, even if I am not without any, I am without any kriya, I am not a karta bhokta, then aham kim sarva sharirishu ekaha uta anekaha. So, akriya atma, that kind of akriya atma I, are there multiple such eyes? Because each and every sharira will have an eye, atma. So are there multiple atmas or I am one? Asya samsarasya karta kaha iti dvitiya prashnasya ayam ashayah. What is the idea with the second question of asking who is the creator of this world? Asya samsarasya karta kashchana asti va. Is there a creator or it has randomly come about from anu? Atoms and molecules, and then they're just Big Bang theory in the modern language. But then Nayayikas have their own way of saying that anus come together, etc. Athava ayam samsara swayam utpannaha. So whether it has come about on its own, as a second question. First is there a creator, first of all? Yadi kashchana karta asti tari. If you say yes, there nothing can come about without a karta, there has to be some creator. Saha karta kim jivaha uta ishvara. Have I created it? Not I, but any jiva. Are there many jivas who are constructed like a palace? They have made this world, or ishvara karta? Yadi ishvara karta tada स ईश्वर किम एक देशे स्थित परिच्छिन्न उत स ईश्वर व्यापक. सो दैट ईश्वर, इफ ईश्वर इज द कर्ता नॉट जीव संसार कर्ता, देन इज दैट ईश्वर इन सम पर्टिकुलर लोकेशन लिमिटेड, लाइक इन अदर, यू नो, अदर रिलीजन्स. पूज्य स्वामी जी से, यू नो, or father in heaven. So what is that father in heaven who is the creator of this world? So, O Lord, who is sitting in heaven, that heaven is a limited place because this is definitely not heaven. This place here right now, I don't feel it is heaven. So the people who teach religion saying that you will go to Nitya Swarga, they don't have a concept of Swarga, we don't have a concept of heaven. So the heaven is something which on judgment day, you will be sent there and that's it. Or sent to hell and that's it. End of story. Forever. But the person who thinks that God is the creator of the world sitting in heaven, did he create that heaven? So did he create the heaven by sitting in the heaven? No, can't be. Circular logic. I mean, mutual dependence. So where did he sit before creating heaven? Let alone this world. If he created this world by sitting in heaven, that heaven is separate from this world, which may be acceptable to some, but the God is also limited. Because he is limited by this world. This world he has created is separate from this world. So parichinna, ishara parichinna bhavati. But if you further your inquiry into that idea, where was he sitting when he created this heaven also? If the heaven is not created by him, then he is not ishara, because he is not karta of the heaven. If he created the heaven, then where was he before he created heaven? Where was he sitting? That space, wherever he was sitting, was that space created by him or not? If not, then he is not that Akashakarta, Deshakarta. If he did create it, then before that, where was he? So this idea of being limited somewhere in space and time and creating something else is invalidated by mere question. Vicharam na sahate. So that idea that the world was created itself is questionable. Even in our systems, our darshanas. But it is not that drastic, because we say Bhagavan has become this entire world Ishwar has become, as though. It is not that he has created anything per se. Sa Ishwara kim ekadeshe sthitah parichinna uta sa Ishwara vyapakah. Is he vyapaka tattva? He has pervaded this universe. As this universe, he has pervaded. Yadi Ishwara vyapakah. So he knows, because he has listened to all this. Tarkadrishti has listened, and the teaching is in such a manner that Agraja Deva's dream is answering Tarkadrishti's questions. So yadi Ishwaraha vyapakaha tarihi yatha vyapaka vyapakad akasha jivaha bhinnaha tatha Ishwaradapi jivaha bhinnaha. Even if the Ishwara Tattva, Brahma Tattva is Vyapaka, all pervasive, still Akasha is also all pervasive, but Jiva is not Akasha. Jiva is different from Akasha. Similarly, Jiva is different from Ishwara. This is possible. Or Athava Ishwara Jivaha Abhinnaha, or he is not different. Muktehe Karanam Kim, what is the Karana of Mukti? Mukte karanam kiti iti tritiya prashnasya ayam abhipraya. What is the idea there? Mukte karanam kim jnanam uta karma uta upasanam uta ubhayam. Ubhayam iti pakshe. Whether the karana for mukti moksha is jnana or karma or upasana or both karma and upasana. Ubhayam iti pakshe. Both, but which both? Karma and upasana was mentioned earlier, it can also be jnana and karma. Jnana and upasana also, all combinations are possible. So, ubhayamiti pakshe, kim jnana karmani, uta jnana upasane, uta karma upasane. All three combinations are possible if you say both. So, this will be analyzed now, each question, aham kaha iti prashnasya uttaram. And in this context, all the darshanas will be talked about. So people who say that, oh, I don't know other darshanas, these all will be covered now. So what are the viewpoints of other darshanas? Because they are going to end up confusing the sadhaka otherwise. So these questions will be answered, and then Advaita will be established. We'll look at it more in the next part. Sukam nityam sat prakasham vyapakam namarupa adhishthanam buddhye bodhyam buddher drukyatva nirmala param sarvedanta vidyam pratyak paramaha tadeva annamatva nirmishitamatihi tat sat. Namaste.
Namaste. Namaste. Hari Om. Namaste.